High School, number 24, Kobe Bryant.
Mr. Referee, you got a sub. Yeah, I'm coming off the bench, but I'm not a scrub. Fresh out of high school, went pro, I got a plug. With six man of the year, it's just not enough. I've been plotting bruh since I was rocking Nautica. With the Jordan 10s, and I must have read the bottom of them 100 times. Cause your accomplishments gave me confidence, so when I shoot, never think I'ma miss. Just trying to catch up, no condiment. Had an incident and I've been using condoms since. 5 rings, 1 MVP. But to be one better than you, I had to triple me.
It's son of a be real. Back here again, your boy P Sharp. Before we start, first I want to say follow us on Twitter and Instagram. Now we have an Instagram, so follow us on Twitter and Instagram. LBR Sports 901. LBR Sports 901.
Wait, is that 901 for both of them or 901?
Yes, 901. Okay. For both of them. Don't say 901. You say 901, but don't actually put an O in there. Yeah. LBR Sports 901. And also, follow the Facebook page, YouTube, and we are on Spotify.
We air where?
Let's be real. All right, I'm back again. My co-host.
What up? Seven Two Shakir.
What up, though? Savage.
And with today's Skyder.
Oh, I like Skyder. Skylito coming back from Dallas.
Yes. So he's going to be here today. But yeah. We got another special guest host who will be on the show quite often. How do you explain this? He's a huge John Wall fan.
Unfortunately.
So we're going to get a whole bunch of trolls. John Wall coming
league,
forward.
Respect it.
So introduce yourself to the people.
My name's Aston Keaton. AKA Coolbreeze, you can call me Coolbreeze.
Coolbreeze.
Thanks for having me on the show, guys.
And he literally is Coolbreeze because he was here like 15 minutes late to the podcast.
Hey. Black people. My first time.
Black people.
Here, man.
Bust them out. All right, man.
I'm going to beat you here next time. Watch.
I doubt it. You've never beat me anywhere. I'm always first.
First of all. All
right, man.
That's because your dad drove hat.
Oh, man. As y'all can see, we go way back.
Most like four flats on a Cadillac.
So, especially these two. So, back to the sports news. First up, more free agency news happened. My team, Chicago Bulls, Jabari Parker signed a 2-year, $40 million deal. The second year is the team option with Chicago. So, I guess I'll start first. This is my team.
Go ahead.
I love it.
You got it.
I love it. I love the contract. Jabari Parker, I know he stays hurt. He averaged 20 points a game a couple years ago before he tore his ACL. But, like, the contract is perfect. If it doesn't work out, it's a team option, not a player option. That means he gone next year. If it works out, perfect.
You comfortable giving somebody $20 million that's always injured? No, that's injury prone.
With the team option next year, yes.
Are you seriously asking that question there? Are you seriously asking that question there?
Yeah.
Grizzlies not signing Chandler Parsons?
Man, don't get me started on Pam Parsons, though.
We're past the Grizzlies.
You're new to this, so let me break it down. We don't talk Grizz talk unless we have an episode for them. Because exactly. We can talk literally this whole episode about the Grizzlies.
This personal vendetta that you have.
Man, fire Chris Wallace. Don't get me started.
So back to the Bulls.
Back to the regular question. So you're comfortable giving them $20 million?
Yes, even for 1 year.
Yes, because the money had to go somewhere. We had salary cap space.
Did it, though?
Yeah, actually does. There is something. Well, I forgot what happens. You get charged tax.
Yeah, you guys spend all your money.
I didn't know that.
You never got to spend your money. That's why like teams who have cap space, they trade for bad contracts or contracts mm-hmm. that expire.
They have like 1 year deals for like huge amounts of money.
To fill the cap space. So might as well. Man, yeah,
why tell me somebody this. They make and bring something to the squad. Right.
And you know, hometown, you know, that's his hometown.
I have none against Jabari Parker. I've liked him since he was at Duke. But he's just been injury prone. So it's like we've never really been able to see what kind of player he can be.
Right.
But
that 1 year, like I said, 1 year he was averaging what, 20 and 6?
I think it was last year.
Last year when he
came back.
He was putting up Jabari been in?
Three.
Four,
it's been four,
4
years.
Years. Okay. Yeah.
They've been hurt two of them, essentially. So.
From my point of view, the way I see it, I thought that y'all should have drafted Michael Porter Jr. because y'all needed wing scoring in general. Yeah. And Michael Porter Jr. has injury history anyway. But now you're getting a proven commodity with Jabari Parker. Even if it's just for 1 year, you can just test and see how he does. I mean, that's – I always say he's like a young Carmelo because he know how to put the ball in the hoop. Yeah. And in y'all's offense, y'all need somebody that can put the ball in the hoop aside from just Zach LaVine. Yeah. The only thing that'll probably be an issue is that Zach LaVine and Jabari Parker don't play defense. Which will be new for
who does play defense?
Andre Robertson, as you know.
I'd much rather get buckets than though.
I agree. This, and even especially in the Eastern Conference where scoring is really at a premium. You need somebody that can put the ball in the hoop, and I think Jabari would be a good fit. Hopefully he doesn't get hurt. I don't think he will get hurt for some reason. I feel like he's gonna be. It's a contract year technically for him because after this year, if he does well, they're going to sign him. If he doesn't do well, they're letting him go, and he's going to get signed for way less than $20 million wherever he goes after that. So, I mean, I think it's a low-risk move for Chicago. It's a good move for Jabari to be closer to home and to be in a familiar environment. And he's not a bad person. I mean, it's a good risk to take, in my opinion.
What does it do for the Bucks?
I honestly don't think it really – let me choose my words carefully. I don't know if it, because he's a good player, but I don't know because he has been hurt. Mm. I don't know if it really hurt. It don't really hurt them because even though he averaged 20 points a game a year with Greek Freak, they never really found a way to play them together.
True.
Yeah.
So it probably
because Greek Freak was playing really his position, even though Greek Freak was like a point forward type.
But he's really a small forward. And they got him playing power forward. Even though in today's game where it's, you know, the position this basketball, he's still technically a small forward. That's probably, and that's why I want to go back with your defense comment. Mm. He might be better on defense as a small forward. Now, I'm not going to bank on it, but who knows? He'll be a better defender than he was at power forward. I don't know if he still won't be a good defender, but it'll be.
And that's why I said, I was like, he's like Carmelo in that he's young enough that he needs to play the three right now because at the four, he's solid, but he's still not going to be guarding like Draymond or something. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? So, I think him being Chicago will be a good fit, and y'all just might make the playoffs next year. Honestly,
yeah, we actually have a shot.
When you think about who in the East,
LeBron gone, so Cleveland at this.
Never mind. We got a new segment called Troll Tonight. I'm gonna keep my bold prediction for that.
Oh, okay.
Jesus.
All right. Ask what? Coolbreeze.
Coolbreeze.
I feel like it's a move. Like Marcus said, y'all could have made moves for Michael Porter Jr., but Jabari Parker is kind of, like you said, a proven commodity at this point. We don't know what Michael Porter Jr. can do. Don't know what he's going to do in the league. So it's like you could have took a risk on him, and now you're really taking a risk on Jabari. Mm. But if he stays healthy, he might be what y'all need, honestly. I kind of hate that y'all didn't get both almost. Because that probably could have made a deep impact at that point.
I ain't going to lie, though. Wendell Carter.
Wendell Carter balling, man.
I know some league, but, man, we need
to. Duke.
And the way he been looking.
Sharky hating on Duke, but you got two Duke boys on your team.
I ain't going to hate on Duke. I don't like Duke. I mean, well, put it this way. I used to hate Duke when I was younger. I don't hate them. As I gotten older, I've become.
Grayson
Allen. You know why I hated them?
Why?
Huh?
Why? Because they win too much?
No. They did win too much, but who was their main? Who were they top type players? Who were they?
White guys?
Exactly.
Man, don't hate on J.J. Reddy, man.
You hate
J.J. Reddy. Hating on white guys.
Nah. It ain't so much that, but it's like Christian Laettner. Like, it was easy to hate players.
Okay,
like,
first of all, Christian Laettner was a dirty dude. Right. It's not hard to hate
this slander of the Duke Blue Devils.
I'm not against Duke at all.
Like, I like, even though I hated the Grayson Allen stuff, I didn't have no problem with Grayson Allen. I mean, he did have some tripping incidents. But,
hey, he's balling out.
Yeah.
Hey. With the trap jazz.
So, it's not the white jazz. Black dynamic. It's just certain players y'all had that had, like, Christian Laettner, who was like, it made it easy to hate y'all.
Duke finna really make you mad now. They going to be getting one and done players now.
Well, I don't hate them for that. Because they are.
They finna be a powerhouse of recruiting now. Yeah.
All right, man.
But it's a good move. Good move for Chicago. I think, like I said, I think y'all made playoffs next year. So, we'll see what happens. All right.
So, next topic. Well, we're still on free agency.
This is going to be an interesting one.
The fall of Isaiah Thomas.
I disagree with that.
The fall.
I'm not going to say. I'm saying the fall money-wise. I'm not saying the fall. Okay.
The financial fall financially, of Isaiah Thomas.
I got to take
so how do you feel about that, Tim?
He wanted the Brinks truck, didn't he?
I got to be completely honest. The Nuggets are my 2K team, so I really, really know how they run and systematically, and I got to say Isaiah Thomas is the perfect fit for them.
Off the bench, too?
Off the bench. Ooh, off the bench. Perfect. Off the bench.
Jamal
because,
Murray.
Like, their backup point guard was Devin Harris.
Jermaine Nelson.
It's Jermaine Nelson.
Yeah, Harris.
Is he injured or something? Like, I played with him online in 2K. I ain't seen Jermaine Nelson
yet. They signed him, like, in the middle of the season or something.
Okay. Hey, their backup point guard is Devin Harris. If you replace him with somebody that can score 20 points a game in little IT, I love it. I love it.
Can he still give you 20 points?
Yes.
Yes. Well, did you not watch him with the Lakers before he went out? Like, he was
first of all, no. I'm not watching no Lakers. I have not watched the Lakers since Kobe stopped.
Okay, well, that's my arch enemy right here.
My arch enemy right here is the primary Lakers person. I don't watch the Lakers at all.
But no, I think IT is still that 20 point. He can give you 20.
I agree.
Especially against a bench point guard. He's going to light them up.
The thing about Isaiah Thomas that's like really is this is a eye-opener for all NBA players is if you are hurt, sit your tail down. See,
Kawhi Leonard.
Yes, exactly. Like, sit your tail down because Isaiah Thomas was balling for the Boston Celtics in the playoffs until he got hurt. And when he got hurt, he tried to come back, you know, in the midst of, you know, his sister dying and then him with the hip surgery and you being so close to the NBA Finals, of course you're going to want to play. But at the end of the day, one, you weren't going to be LeBron James. Two, you're not going to get paid. One, because you're small and then you have that injury history already. Before that, he was going to get paid, like, by somebody. Yeah. Like, probably by Boston, because Boston was going to open up the bank account for him. And at this point, he's making what, $1 million? And I mean, not 1 million. 1 year, $7 million.
No.
He's on two million.
$2 million.
Wow.
Wow. That, like, to go from making, well, about to make $100-something million to $2 million. that is insane. Yeah. And I'm all about players making their bread. Like, if you want to make your bread, do what you gotta do to make your bread. Kawhi Leonard, Jimmy Butler, whoever else. Like, you know your worth. And if the team ain't going to give you the money, then I'd be like, play hardball. I ain't doing this.
Let me ask you this, Savage. Is it more that if you're injured, you should sit down? The biggest takeaway, it should be that, or is it that these teams aren't loyal?
I do agree. Teams are not loyal to
the
players.
I'm saying we should be the bigger point to take away from this whole situation. This? Is that if you're injured, sit down, or is it that?
Both. Because if you're, I said this, in your contract year. Mm-hmm. So he was in a contract year.
Okay.
If you're in a contract year and you injured, you got to get paid, you might want to chill out. You know what I'm saying? And then teams will cut you off the moment you show any ounce of being old or being slow. Like, they will do that. And that's why I talked about Klay Thompson. When he gets old and he ain't playing good defense, they will let him go. And I'm like, Klay, make your money. Like, for real. Mm-hmm. Because you ain't going to be able to make that money later on. And of course he's a team player. He wants to keep the core together. But like I said, the moment he turns slow, it's over. Like, they're gonna ship him out. They're gonna cut him. Do whatever they gotta do for the betterment of the team. And IT is a prime example of that. I would have sat down. Kyrie been sitting down. Like, Kyrie ain't played.
Kyrie been hurt before.
Exactly.
Before he got to the league. So he know how.
Exactly. Yep. And Kyrie about to get paid by Boston or New York or whoever want him. Mm-hmm. So that's what I take away from it. Is
that's what we was going into. But Aston, you got anything?
No. You good? You good on that? I don't.
Didn't watch the Lakers play, so you really can't comment.
It's hard to comment because I didn't watch him.
You watch the Cavs?
Well, I didn't watch him in LA.
You watch the Cavs, bro?
Yeah, I watched him in the Cavs. Okay. I didn't feel like he was a fit for the Cavs system anymore.
Yeah,
just for the simple fact, for one, he's small.
Yeah, he's very small.
The rest of that Cavs lineup is kind of huge, and at that point, I didn't see him meshing well with LeBron from the get go. Because a lot of ball dominant players.
Yeah. And I say he's ball dominant.
Yeah.
He got
saw that
dominant.
In Boston. Mm-hmm. Like, Boston had nobody but him. They picked up Kyrie the next year and got rid of him. But besides Isaiah that year when he went off before his hip injury, who was really scoring besides your role players or, you know, your rookies?
Mm.
So really nobody. And at that point, he was able to control and do his own thing. LA,
he played good with LA.
He played well.
He played good. Yeah.
He played really good coming out the bench.
Mm.
Before we move on, y'all remember that season? When Earl Boykins averaged the most points in the fourth quarter.
I remember that.
I just wanted to throw that out there. Shout out to the short people, man. Shout out to the short people.
Because you short.
Yeah, exactly. Somebody got to hold it down.
But yeah, what do y'all see his long – is he going to be in Denver going forth? Like, what's – because he's on a one-year deal. And I think he still wants to get paid. He ain't getting paid $100 million.
Yeah, he's not getting paid from Denver.
How old is he? He got to be like almost 30.
He's 29. He's 29 turning 30.
So
it won't be from Denver. If he wants to get paid, it's not going to be from Denver. For the fact that they just paid Jokic. They just paid Will Barton. Gary Harris, contract's coming
Gary
up.
Gary Harris. Jamal Murray at some point.
Jamal, yeah, exactly. So they got contracts coming up for all
but
that
at that
young
point,
players.
Who's going to pay him?
Well, I'll say this. Money. If IT can understand that he's –
it won't be 100 mil, but he'll get paid.
If IT can understand that he's a six-man type of player or a spark plug, he'll get paid.
Yeah.
as long as Jamal Crawford getting paid, Eric Gordon getting paid, and Lou Williams getting paid, there's a fit for you somewhere.
Yeah, Crawford is that guy, though.
He is.
Yeah, but I'm saying Jamal, he won't get.
Is he still on sign?
Yep, he's still on sign.
Crawford. Yeah. I thought he was with Minnesota.
No, he's a free agent.
Okay.
It was 1 year deal.
Okay. But yeah, like if he can understand that role and not want to be like, I want to start, then he'll be okay. Don't fall for the mistake that like Carmelo, the same one, Carmelo AI, where you won't be a bench player. Like, be a bench player, make your money, you still can get your points. Like,
right.
Like, he could easily fit on a contending team. Like, I mean, I hate to say this, but he could easily fit on Golden State Warriors if he wanted to. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, I won't give no any ideas out there.
You ain't got to get them ideas.
Sean Livingston is getting a little older, man. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, Sean Livingston is a walking bucket from mid-range while you're playing.
That's a homie. He should not be in the league, but God's playing, bro.
Man.
But, yeah, that's what I get on IT, man.
All right, man, Took. So, this is so we talked about Kyrie. Floor is yours, man. You said you wanted to discuss a little bit. We discussed a little bit about Kyrie last show. So we talking about, this is straight Boston Celtics topic, essentially. So first, why would Kyrie leave the Celtics?
I think Kyrie Irving would leave the Celtics because he, like I said on the last show, he wants his own team. If you think about the Celtics, that wouldn't be anybody's team. That'd be Brad Stevens' team.
Yeah. If not Jason Tatum's team.
Spurs. Mm-hmm. Similar to the Spurs, where it's like people say it's Tim Duncan team, but you still had Parker, you still had Ginobili, but it was Pop's system.
Yep.
Yeah. I think Kyrie doesn't want a system. Like I said, he wants a ring. Of course, I think he wants another one, but he wants to be the man where he is. Mm-hmm. He wants to be, like I said, the king of basketball. It'll shock me if he don't be with the Knicks next season. It'll shock me.
But who do? Okay, what is it? Porzingis, the Knicks have?
Yeah.
Okay, other than that,
Kevin Knox.
Cap space.
And Coach Fizdale.
They could sign Jimmy Butler, too.
In order for him to win a ring anywhere else, he's going to need a quality core group.
I agree, but it's like, you can't. He's not going to expect one the first year he gets there.
It's not
like,
even the first year.
If Kyrie and Jimmy Butler join and go to the Knicks with Kevin Knox and Porzingis, With Coach Fizdale?
In the Eastern Conference,
that's making noise off the top. That's a top three team, I think, in itself, in the East.
But to go with the West toe-to-toe, scoring-wise.
They'll get there. That'll be their first season together, too.
Yeah, that core.
Like, Rome wasn't good overnight. Let's get to the finals first. Let's beat the Celtics first.
Yeah. I'll say this about Kyrie. I definitely agree with you that Kyrie, he wants his team. Like, mm-hmm. And I say that because even when he was in Cleveland before LeBron, he was like, I'm going to stay in Cleveland because this is my team. LeBron ain't here. And when LeBron's talking about going there, Kyrie wasn't just cool with that. He was like, I mean, you can come, but at some point, I'm going to get out of here and get my own team, which he did. And now that he's in Boston, you got all these nice pieces there. And they're, even if Kyrie leaves, I still think Boston will be a good team.
Yeah, great team.
If they put Terry Rozier in the starting lineup, they still will be okay. Yep. That being said, I think Kyrie will be a good fit in New York because, one, I think New York going to tank this year, like we said last show. New York going to tank. They're going to sit unicorn down all year.
So they're going to have another top three pick coming with potentially Kyrie and James.
Exactly. That would be a nice little pick. You can get Zion, Unicorn, Kyrie, Butler, and Knox. Bro, that's like, that team can't compete.
Can we see Zion in college first? Besides seeing high school dunk competition,
I want to see.
He is with Coach K though.
I want to see him in college too, but I think he's gonna be straight.
I mean, you know this.
I do want to see more than just dunk.
I mean, Duke is all in the NBA, so
first of all, we all know besides Vince Carter and a couple other people, dunking ain't gonna get you too far. Not no more.
I mean, if Zion gonna be a role player for the Knicks with the scoring gonna be from theoretically Kyrie, Jimmy Butler, and Unicorn, you're going to be okay. Put Zion at the folk. Go get rebounds. Go dunk. Go do whatever. You know.
Put him at the folk?
Yeah.
That's what he's going to play in the NBA. By the way, what is he now? Draymond Green is 6'6".
Oh, what's Zion's?
He's about 6'7". 6'8".
Yeah. But, I mean, like I said.
In NBA? Have you seen today's NBA game?
First of all, I wouldn't have him at power. If he can shoot, PJ he would be straight.
A power forward.
So. He like 6'5".
He's 6'5".
Yeah. But anyway, like going back to Kyrie, like I do agree that that he wants his own team. He wants to be the man. And I don't think that's a bad thing per se with him. He's not a bad guy or a bad person in the locker room. Like, most people enjoy Kyrie being in the locker room, you know. But I think he's like adamant about, I want this to be my team. And if he goes to New York, that, I don't know if it's going to be considered Porzingis' team, but Kyrie going to New York would be a big deal. Like, if Amari going to New York was a big deal, if Carmelo going to New York was a big deal. You know, like, but like, Kyrie going is going to be a huge, like, massive deal for the New York. Like, the Knicks, bruh, like, that's going to be crazy because the Knicks ain't been good in a, like, legitimately good.
Literally since 99.
Yeah, like in a long time.
Literally, 99.
Yeah. I don't think Porzingis will have a problem with saying Kyrie this
jersey. I don't think so either. Oh, I don't either.
Welcome. I think he'll definitely. I think
he's
like,
he's tired of losing.
Man. Breath of fresh air.
Yeah. He humble too, though.
Yeah. And piggyback off of what y'all said, I agree because the Knicks were the top team on his list when he demanded a trade from Cleveland.
Yep.
When he demanded the trade, I think he had New York, he had Phoenix, and I think.
Why Phoenix? I don't know.
He'd be the man. Booker,
yeah, he would and be the man.
Yeah,
because even with Booker there, he's the, it's, we gonna look at this Kyrie's team. So
man, he need to go ahead and go to the Clippers, trying to be the man.
I actually think that's a possibility as
Jerry
well.
Jerry West,
you know what? Exactly,
sleep on
exactly.
The
because
hey, don't sleep
because
on
watch this right here. I, like my method has changed Kyrie since last week because if Kyrie goes to the Clippers. And you got Kyrie there with Jerry West.
Man, I really just realized what I said.
And Kawhi might, like, I ain't going to lie, because Kawhi might not go to L.A., depending on how we do this year without Kawhi.
Yeah.
Why we spend money on Kawhi if you already got in-house talent? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So you can
think put, you, smart about this.
Yeah, you can have Kyrie and Kawhi in L.A., and you still going to attract people because it's been proven before when they had CP3, DeAndre Jordan, and Blake Griffin. They got talent there, just didn't do nothing with it.
Yeah.
You know? So, yeah. And I think Jerry West can make that happen, honestly.
They had Doc Rivers, too.
And I don't think Kyrie care about being a Laker or a Clipper. He's like, I want my team.
He hear me. Doc Rivers.
Now, he can go. Now, he can go. Doc Rivers can go.
He
can go
the same, though. He signed their extension, too. So, the Clippers are really trying not to, like, lose out like this. They because Doc Rivers ain't been coaching a losing team like he did in Orlando. Rivers. So,
his son gets traded from your own team.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that's a possibility. I think so. I think it's a possibility.
Right on.
Yep.
Right.
So, next course of action, or next question, are the Celtics becoming the Patriots?
Describe what that means. Describe what that means.
So, lost on that one.
You know, the Patriots always, they don't pay their players. Well, I ain't going to say, they don't pay their players. They got their system set up.
Mm-hmm.
They use their system. Their players leave, and Kyrie's still going to be good wherever he goes, but players are not as good when they leave. Avery Bradley. Jay Crowder. AOT got to Utah. And once again, another system similar like Boston, San Antonio. But IT got hurt. But don't they and think about it? They get rid of the players before
Danny Ainge wins every trade.
what New England does, they always they work with lesser talent too.
I think
in that regard, but they're not beating anybody.
Yeah,
that's where I was coming from. I was like, are they becoming the Patriots? Not are they the Patriots now? Are they starting to become them?
But, I can see that. I can definitely see that. Like you guys said, just the whole system and the way of just doing things. You know, Avery Bradley did start declining. Jay Crowder, what is he doing with the Trap Jazz? Like, you got a point there, now that I think about it. But we got to see him healthy, and we got to see him win before we can call them the Patriots.
That's what I said.
As much as I hate the Patriots, they are. they're great.
So, speaking of the Patriots, would they be trading somebody before they decline? Yeah, like Gordon Hayward or something. I mean, I don't think they're going to trade.
I wouldn't be shocked if they do something.
I don't
like
think they're going to trade Gordon Hayward because they want to see him at least work with Brad Stevens at least until the trade deadline. Yeah. And I don't think Brad Stevens would do his former college player like that. But
it's like what we said with the player, with the teams not being loyal to players. Like the Celtics, they
you numbers
that.
On a spreadsheet, sir.
Huh?
You numbers on a spreadsheet. You all business at that point.
Yep.
And that's why that's why I had no problem like with team. I had no problem with teams do long. That's why I actually like what the players are doing. I didn't mind KD going to Golden State.
I was like, I don't either.
Y'all, and I didn't mind LeBron going to Miami. That whole everybody being mad about that. I was like, they gonna get rid of you.
Yep.
If you don't perform.
Exactly.
Honestly,
you take care of yourself.
I think that started with Vince Carter. People didn't think he was gonna leave Toronto.
Yep.
Also, if you guys haven't checked out the Vince Carter documentary on Netflix,
man,
check it out.
You check it out.
I heard about like him and his mama. They didn't want to give him like the family room or something. Like something along those lines where they was like tired of him basically before they traded him to New Jersey. Mm-hmm. But so, I watched that though.
Yeah, it's, you know, you see the same things happen. It's just like, you know, the fans become to love you and expect you to be there all year long, but y'all don't know what happens in this front office and don't know. Like, these folks will get rid of me.
Instantly.
In a matter of seconds if I do something wrong or if I get hurt.
Like, there's literally only like, what, three no trade clauses? in the NBA? Dirk, Kobe,
Melo.
Melo. And LeBron, yeah. So four. Like four out of 400 players. So like what? Was that 1%? 1% of players have a no trade clause. Like that's crazy. But yeah, I can see what you're saying there. They got to win something for me first before you put them anywhere near. I mean, of course, it's Boston. They had a deep history of winning. But recently, aside from 2008,
it's been that long.
They got, yeah. They got to win something for me. And they might pretty soon. I mean, unless they run into the Warriors this year.
How soon do you guys see a Celtics-Lakers finals?
Next year. Not this year, but the following year.
I was going to say, you're so disrespectful.
No, Warriors win next year. I mean, let's be real. Like, Warriors win next year no matter who they playing. But like,
so is that without Kyrie?
That's the thing. I was like, I gotta wait next summer.
Good one, Ashley.
I gotta wait next summer because I gotta see Klay Thompson. What happens with Golden State too? Because
true,
if they still beat the same team.
I think Klay going to LA. But
I said the same thing.
If they keep DeMarcus Cousins, I mean,
I said that too.
Exactly.
I'm like, Seven over here trying to be a prophet and stuff, man.
Hey, once I'm right, y'all can look back at this and be like, dang, man.
That's what next summer.
Next summer for them,
right? But yeah, I mean, so next year with Boston, you looking if Kyrie leaves, I think Kyrie's gone, honestly, because I don't see him staying in Boston. Mm-mm. I see him in New York, whether it's New York or Brooklyn. Well, yeah, whatever. So you have, I would assume, Terry Rozier, Jaylen Brown, Hayward, Tatum, and Al Horford might be gone at some point.
He ain't going nowhere.
By 2 years? In 2 years?
He ain't going.
You don't think so?
Okay. He liked the system.
Okay.
And he want
to
win.
The system works for him, to be honest.
It works. Yeah. Great for him.
Yeah. So I do think that's like a team in the East. But in 2 years, thinking about experience with Tatum and Brown, I love Brown. Brown's game is like real.
Folks underrate him,
man. Honestly, Brown, like, because Tatum get the spotlight, but
he does.
If you just watch Brown, like, what game was it? I think
Brown is the better all around player. Jason Tatum is the more.
Brown is basically like a Kawhi Leonard type player.
Exactly. He's
like, he's that's for real.
Kawhi Leonard.
A smaller Kawhi Leonard.
Yeah, so you got a Kawhi Leonard type. You're going to have Tatum, who is a walking bucket. You got Hayward, who, in my opinion, enjoys being in that secondary piece. Like, he don't got to be a star. But he can shoot, he can score, he can defend. Mm-hmm. You got three, like, wings that can do that. It don't matter who the point guard. Long the point guard can play defense and tough, and that's Terry Rozier.
And Al Horford. That's exactly what he is.
And you got Al Horford. Like, they, yeah.
Most consistent big man in the league.
Yeah, well, I don't know about that.
Consistency?
Let me think.
He's consistent, dude.
Yeah, he's pretty consistent.
I think he was like top four in like the fantasy basketball. Mm-hmm. He was like top four, like big man, just like off of consistency.
I don't doubt he also. He is. All right, so
before we move on, I got $20 saying that this will be the Christmas game. One of the Christmas games.
Lakers and Celtics?
Yeah.
I said that should be a Christmas game.
That might
one
be.
Of them.
I promise.
You know, they try to hype up the Rockets and the Warriors, which is
nothing. I do not. When they first went, LeBron first went to Lakers, I was like, Lakers. I know somebody said Lakers Golden State. I was like, no, Lakers Celtics.
Give me
Golden State Houston again or something like
young
that.
Young players, because you're going to have Brown.
You know, they're still trying to make the Rockets a thing, so I think they're going to put
us. That's why I said Golden State Houston.
Golden State Rockets, Celtics, Lakers.
I'm not going to lie to you. The Rockets kind of scare me right now.
Scaring?
No,
why'd you even have faith in them before? Like, no, did you really think they were a team?
Did they even match Clint?
Completely? It don't matter.
Clint's after. Yep.
So you got him. You got Trevor. You got like valuable.
I don't have Trevor
pieces.
Anymore.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh, okay.
They don't have those valuable pieces. Did you say he signed it?
No, he ain't signed it. He's after.
That's what I'm saying. So you got valuable pieces that you need for later on. They may not even be with you next year.
Mm. You know what happened, right? That guy, Chris Paul, $40 million a season. You know, he's paid more than LeBron.
Hey, I'm not gonna lie, my
he's
dad
paid more
said,
than LeBron.
Why would you
that's
get
crazy.
Chris Paul $40 million, and I had
for 4 years.
Four years.
He's gonna be 37 making.
I'm staying giving it for one.
Wow.
Yeah.
I don't know. I never
four?
Saw. Chris Paul was a good player. Is a good player and everything, but $40 million.
He's aging. Yeah.
So Lakers Celtics on Christmas, I can buy some of that because even the story of that is like you gotta
start somewhere.
Got Brandon Ingram, Kuzma, Lonzo against Brown, Tatum, and all these other Rozier, young players,
LeBron
and Kyrie.
Come on,
oh yeah, that's
a
seller.
Come on,
yeah, book that. I like Golden State versus Rockets though. For another game.
Can somebody? I mean, I'd rather see the Warriors and the Nuggets. Honestly,
that's mine.
No,
I'd rather see the Warriors and the Nuggets.
Warriors fans be like.
The Rockets are so overrated to me, bro.
That just came to my mind when we said Rockets. I was like,
great man, great mind, single like, great mind, single like.
You just took
the Rockets are so overrated.
Or they might do Warriors and whatnot because Boogie ain't coming back.
And the Clippers,
we see Warriors and Sixers.
I watched it.
I don't know. But I mean, the Warriors going to win, so it's just like.
It still won't be the, you know, like them versus Rockets. That's the Western Conference.
So what y'all want, the Warriors versus Cavs again?
That's a game I'm not watching. I say
Colin Sexton for three.
I say Warriors Rockets. And I love Philly. I say Warriors Rockets. So.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I don't see that being a game being watched, to be honest. Yeah. That'd be like Lakers and Celtics going to be a primary game like everybody's watching. Yeah, exactly. But if you tell me. The Denver Nuggets versus the Warriors.
It won't be watched.
I'm clicking off.
Denver ain't got to that.
In the meantime, the Nuggets gonna have a top three seed this season. Bet
they might. So speaking of the Lakers,
could have kept that for the troll or not?
They ain't my troll.
But I mean, that's the point of the segment.
Speaking of the Lakers,
savage.
Speaking of the Lakers, speaking of the Lakers,
here we go.
So y'all know that they spray painted a mural somewhere in Los Angeles. Very nice mural.
Man, it was a great mural.
It was dope. I always wonder like how the heck do people like do those things? Even on top of like the expressway they do. Like how y'all do them upside down? But anyway, they had a mural of LeBron that said King LA, and several times it's been
Kobe'd.
Kobe. That's like it's been Kobe, and I'm a Kobe fan. So
hey, this about to get real.
So why do y'all think some Lakers fans don't welcome LeBron? I'm a Lakers fan. I used to hate.
You go answer that first.
All right, so I'm a Lakers fan. First. I used to dislike LeBron when I was in high school, but I was in high school, so I was immature. I didn't have a really understanding mindset.
You understood basketball, right?
I understood basketball. But I was like, I don't like LeBron because LeBron ain't better than Kobe. Of course, LeBron better than Kobe now. But I was like,
I didn't expect to hear that.
Thank you for admitting
it.
Thank you for admitting it. A lot of Kobe fans, boy, I tell you, I see Mark.
I'm a realistic Kobe fan now. Now Kobe still put a buckets on there, man. But LeBron better than Kobe. Let's be real. So why do you? I mean, I'm gonna ask y'all since I'm a level headed Lakers fan.
You kind of biased.
Why do you think some Lakers fans do not like LeBron? Like, what's the problem? That's the best player in the NBA.
The reason to me, LeBron is the best player in the NBA, and I hate to say that. It should be like a 1A, 1B, but whatever. But the reason I don't like LeBron is because his mannerisms. He whines too much. He complains
too
much.
That's what all NBA players do. KD whine. Steph Curry whine.
We in the league where acting is a key now.
It's rewarded.
Yeah. Like
flopping.
We can't go back to the 90s where people had.
Look, I think let's be real. Okay. Another reason is why I feel like he's too cocky for his own right.
Steph Curry is cocky.
Yeah, but he wins.
LeBron wins.
Yeah, but he got his butt whooped by the Mavericks the first year, right?
Yeah.
That was a choke job.
I'm not going to say he's gotten better at it, but moments like that is like he's choked at the biggest moments. And a lot of Laker fans would be like, Kobe's.
Never,
he's going to kill LeBron if they ever meet in the finals.
But the thing is, like, nobody pays attention to how many shots Jordan missed that could have won in the game. Kobe goes the same way.
At least Jordan took those shots.
That's fine.
LeBron,
we can say the same thing about KD not doing it sometimes.
LeBron's taking them more in recent history. But before, like, Miami, like first year in Miami, yes. He was, like, very passive in that finals. I remember that. So,
I think he's a passive player, period.
I mean, by nature, last
season was the hungriest I've ever seen LeBron James, honestly.
I think LeBron wants to be passive because he doesn't want to be Jordan. He wants to be Magic Johnson. He wants to be the one to facilitate the offense.
Ooh, I was going to bring that up later on.
Okay, we'll come back to it then. Yeah. But like, I think that's just who he is. He's very passive aggressive anyway, even on social media with the Arthur meme. Like he's not the type of person to be like to come to you and talk to you about it. Like the thing with Kevin Love a couple of years ago, it was like a passive tweet that he sent out to Kevin Love.
So do you think that the Lakers feel fakeness is too hard. What I'm trying to say. Do they sense in LeBron that he's not really...
He's half and half?
He's half and half.
I agree with, because we all know LeBron's there. One, he's playing basketball, duh. But, like, he's also there because he's a businessman as well.
Yeah.
He's doing acting. He's doing, you know, business with his agency. He wants to own a sports team. So I agree that I know that he's there for business as well. So I think some fans who are like diehard Lakers, I'm a diehard Lakers fan too, but like who are like diehard, like, man, forget LeBron. They're like, man, if you're going to be here, be here. You know what I'm saying? And which can't be played out until the season starts. Now, if he starts missing games, which LeBron rarely does, then it's going to be a problem, you know? But I think he's passive by nature, which is good for him as a basketball player because he was passive in Cleveland, but Cleveland had nobody to pass too. Mm. You know what I'm saying? In L.A., he got options.
Does he really?
Yes. Okay. He does.
Okay. Well, here go my take on it. I don't believe they are Laker fans. The ones who are mad about LeBron coming, they're not
Kobe fans.
That's exactly what it is.
I'm also a Kobe fan.
Yeah, but you also, you a Laker fan.
I'm a Laker fan first. Yeah, then Kobe fan.
There are a lot of Kobe fans that, okay, he was playing for the Lakers, so when he retired, yeah, I guess I still support the Lakers because,
man,
that's the only team I cheer for. But they weren't diehard Laker fans. Yeah, they were diehard.
Kobe's legacy is a scare right now. It's just like, oh, LeBron might become the best
some of them,
LA player.
Most of them, all of them.
I was just about to say.
I hear their narrative, but personally, I don't see how those fans would even think that. Like,
but I'm just saying that's what they're thinking. That's like, crazy. Oh, LeBron's gonna come here and start a whole new dynasty here.
Exactly. I hope so.
Like the last 10 years is like, who's the best player, Kobe or LeBron? You know what I'm saying? Then you got LeBron who's coming to Kobe's team, and it's like you trying to destroy our hero's legacy. Mm-hmm. If I was a Lakers fan, that's how I feel. Like of course he's the best player in the league, but it's like, yo, you trying to destroy Kobe's image? I wouldn't say image, but what he's done for the city.
Yeah. But it's not him trying to destroy it. It's just like, you got to move on from Kobe.
Exactly. We needed that. But
do you think the person that we've been debating against him is the right person to do that? Like I said, the last 10 years, this has literally been who's the best player in the league, LeBron and Kobe. I hate we never been able to see that finals. Man. But who's a better player, Kobe, LeBron? Now you have LeBron who's coming to Kobe's team. So it's like, people going to compare their legacies. Period. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? If LeBron wins the championship, we saw in a microwave society that it's like, Kobe, who? As soon as I think that's how it's going to be
I do agree with that narrative where people have forgotten about Kobe almost immediately.
I grew up hating Kobe Bryant. Kobe Bryant. Mm-hmm. But he's the greatest of my generation. Mm-hmm. He's the great, and I can truthfully say that. Mm-hmm. Like growing up when he didn't let Allen Iverson win the championship. I was pissed growing up. Ever since then, my hate for him and Shaq was
been
real.
You short people stuff go, man.
Nah, bro. I've been shy all my life. I've been shy all my life.
I'm proud of Allen Iverson for getting that one
game.
I'm so happy.
Stepping over Tyronn Lue.
One game, like to me, that's enough.
Enough. That was enough.
Because we was a cold team that year. That was we was 16-1 that year.
AI team that year. Man, come on.
Hey, Eric Snow, baby.
Eric Snow.
The King Baby Matumbo.
Yeah,
but you get what I'm saying. Like, for the last 10 years, it's been Kobe or LeBron, and you have people that really rock with Kobe to the point where some people are crying on his last game. Because they never see him in a Laker uniform. And you bring in pretty much his rival to, quote unquote, carry his legacy and bring the city a championship.
It's,
I don't think the Lakers fans will want
his legacy.
That.
It may be just the, like I said.
Or the Lakers legacy.
Are you saying that Kobe continue Magic's legacy?
As far as greatness goes, yeah. So we're going to say the greatness. As far
so why
as
can't
greatness
LeBron
goes.
Come in and do that?
Because growing up, it was either him or Kobe.
Yeah,
because
Kobe got trapped.
Like, out of any Magic team LeBron could have gone to, you went to
the
Lakers.
Yeah, it wasn't like it was Kobe retired and then LeBron came into the league.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure LeBron, Kobe's like, bro, he can tweet all he wants. I don't care. But Kobe's like, y'all really just him to.
Now, Kobe is hating it. I know Kobe. Kobe ain't.
He can tweet what he wants. Let's be real.
Kobe
probably thinking like, no.
Kobe don't like that mess.
He ever said during the season, he came out, was like, when it was the whole LeBron versus MJ debate, he was the one came out, was like, hey.
Don't forget about me.
Exactly. And you got somebody that's retired who's still worried. I don't want to say worried, but he's thinking about his legacy. And then you got LeBron.
I buy somebody.
Like I said, he's still coming. The last 10 years has been either him or Kobe. Mm-hmm. And then I think he's trying to take over his legacy. You know, he's going to wear number 23. So maybe
I think
another
thing LeBron wants to do, he wants to win a championship with three teams, which has never been done from like a standpoint of I'm the best person on this team.
I was just about to say I'm winning
two. Well, that's Robert Orr. Robert Orr won.
Is that a big deal, though?
I mean, to me, it's not, but that's like people are saying that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like how he went to three teams and won a championship while being the best player on that team. You know?
Okay.
I don't see the big deal about that. I mean, it's LeBron. Anywhere he go, he's going to be a contender. But
why is it so big? Why is it so important for the Lakers to win a championship?
With LeBron or just in general? I mean, it's any team that they want to win a championship.
But why is it so emphasized on the Lakers?
Did you not see?
They got the most rings.
How many championships won in the beginning from y'all in the Celtics?
I think like, Boston was, got 17. We got 16.
So, at that point, like, I feel like history played a big factor in that.
And then going back to, like, just that, like, the team's history, every – when you think about the Lakers, even more than Boston, who has more rings, the Lakers are all over the league. Mm-hmm. One, you had Jerry West, who started off with, you know, getting one – he got one ring, but he got one. Then he became the GM around the time where Pat Riley was the coach in the 80s. Magic was the best player. Where Pat Riley at now? Pat Riley's in Miami, winning rings. Magic, he won rings. Where he at now? Lakers, to win rings. Then you got Jerry West. Where he at now? Clippers. He been with the Clippers. Been with the Golden State Warriors. Mm-hmm. Been with the Grizzlies. Got them going. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? With the Lakers as a GM several times. So that's just...
Not to mention Derek Fisher as an ambassador and everything. Like, people make moves in LA.
Yeah. So that's like... that's like, it's like excellence or nothing. Like, don't come in here and be slow, which is why it was like... so terrible when we had like Byron Scott, who was part of like the 80s, but it was like, I mean, let's be real. We had Byron Scott before. We had
Byron Scott.
Rudy Tomjanovich.
Y'all actually played with the year before who got hurt? Lamar Odom got hurt that year or something. Y'all were like a playoff team then. Lamar Odom got hurt and y'all were downhill. I remember that.
Yeah. So that's just the nature and the culture of the Lakers. It's like the Yankees. The Yankees won rings every year. Like they just like we expect to win every year. So, I mean, and that rubs people the wrong way. But as a Lakers fan, we're spoiled. We're very microwave. We're very microwave driven in terms of like, we want a ring, we want it now.
Y'all worse than Cowboy fans, man.
I don't know about that. We ain't no Cowboy fans.
I'm going to save that for another day.
I don't know about that.
I told you that before.
Yeah, you did. I remember. It was a high school, maybe.
That's kind of control.
Yeah, I said it.
I don't think I ever seen Lakers shoes.
So the counterpoint was why don't some LeBron fans support the Lakers?
I'm not a LeBron fan. I despise them. So
I hate the Lakers. I'm not a LeBron fan.
Why do you think some LeBron fans don't support the Lakers? So like really, people who are LeBron fans who follow him to wherever he goes, they have to come to LA.
Yeah,
technically now.
One of my homeboys, man. I ain't gonna say his name on him, boy. Man. Yeah, man, it's like, man, LeBron, I fought you to Miami.
I know what he's talking about. I know exactly what he's talking about.
Is that what I think it is?
Huh. Oh. We ain't trying to get sued, y'all. Let's continue, but let's say I know exactly what he's talking about, man.
Lord.
I mean, you got to hop on the bandwagon now.
Honestly, it's kind of like the hype. It's kind of like the same reasoning, essentially, but in reverse. For the Kobe fans, it's like they don't want him.
I mean, look, I look at it like this. If we can get LeBron fans to merge with Lakers fans, why can't we just have world peace and end world hunger? Like,
y'all have metal world peace. You want world peace now?
Did you see metal world peace in the big three? Friday, Wednesday,
exactly. Talking about world peace, metal world. He going ham.
Man got kicked out of a big three game, man.
Really got metal world peace.
That man said, can we get the Bloods and Crips to come?
Exactly. We already in Los Angeles.
This ain't straight out of Compton, bro.
We already in Los Angeles. We got LeBron fans. We got Lakers fans. We can get Crips, Bloods, black people, white people, Trump, the whole world. Like, we can make this happen, right?
I was with you, you said Trump.
Next subject.
Dump the color of a basketball, damn it.
But no, like, people going to really have to get used to LeBron being there for the next, 4 years?
At least three maximum.
I feel like
he's going to retire with
him.
He probably will. Yeah, I feel like that's why the contract is so long.
Okay, his son is going to the ninth grade, mm-hmm. I think.
Yeah.
At least be there for 4 years.
He wants him and his son to play ball at the same time.
I wonder.
And they going to get rid of they getting rid of that rule in 2 years. You can go straight from high school to NBA. So he wants that to happen.
They bringing that back.
You know what? LeBron does own a percent of the Cavs. So he may be like an owner, coach, player kind of deal.
And Dan Gilbert might be on his way out if he keep on tripping.
Exactly.
LeBron going to own the Cavs and live in L.A. while he doing it?
Hey.
I mean, he going to have the money deal with Magic Johnson. He'll have the money.
Hey.
He'll have the money.
Hey, my money move.
And he already owns a percent, so it's like, shoot, get Gilbert out of there.
That'll be a power move. That'll be a power move.
Hey, guess what?
If LeBron buys it from
LeBron got a power team. Maverick Carter.
Yeah, that'd be a power move.
He got a power.
Having the homies.
Hey,
that'll be a power move.
Look who his closest friends are. Chris Paul.
Yeah.
Dwayne Wade.
That'll be a power move.
Power players.
That'll be a power move.
He cool with Melo, too. Melo. because they're in power now.
For the record, I despise LeBron James on the court. Off the court, he's great. He's one of the greatest athletes ever. So like, I just want to throw that out there.
Okay.
Throw that out there.
I might hate him for just being a player.
Yeah. The kind of player that I don't think this should be calling the best. Like,
I feel you, bro.
People, I strongly dislike when people say he's the best, but
talking about now?
Right now.
Okay,
but
right.
It's 1A, 1B because players do certain things. I don't think
I won't get into it. Who's 1B? Durant?
Come on now.
I
won't get into it today, but I disagree with that.
We're going to get into it. Let's get it.
I disagree.
We're going to get into it. Trust me. We're going to get into it.
All right, so what's next, Sharp?
All right.
Speaking of KD, huh?
Yep.
Good segue. So this is how you know we've been podcasting for 3 weeks now. So we up here segueing unintentionally.
Hey, the Lord works in mysterious ways. That's all I got to say. What are we talking about, KD? The Instagram,
yeah,
the Twitter
thing.
I ain't heard this.
Took. Floor is yours on this one. So KD got into it with a fan, or a hater, you want to call it, a regular person. On Twitter, had sent. I forgot what it was, but I mean,
it was a guy that tagged him in one of his posts, just pretty much going at KD, talking about how he sucks or doing whatever. He's comparing him, KD, to other things, and I guess Kevin Durant didn't like it. So he goes into the guy's DM, and they just having like a little DM.
He went in his DM?
He went in the DM. That's the only problem I have with that is you went into another dude's DMs talking about
exactly.
But I have no problem with him commenting and saying what he had to say, though.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, it is Instagram. It is Twitter.
Yeah.
You know, because he's a two-time champion, he's not allowed to speak his mind. Yeah. And I think the media has grown so much to hate KD. It's like anything he do is literally under a microscope. If he show one sign of just speaking his mind, he's soft. He don't need to be doing that. He trying to be hard. He trying to be bad. He trying to be evil. But it's like he just speaking his mind. Mm. But should he have gone into dude DMs?
Now what did he say in a DM? Like, what did he say exactly? Do you know?
Can we find it? Let me see.
I don't know, but I'm like, first of all, Kevin need to chill out. Like, he needs to stop responding to trolls. I mean, like, let's be real. Kevin,
who don't respond to trolls, though?
I personally don't. Like, if you ain't got
that's a lie.
If you ain't got an avatar, I ain't gonna respond to you. Well, okay, look, my brother right here is a troll. I respond to him because I've known him since 99, 2000. Well, earlier than that, honestly. But still, if it's an internet troll that's on my Twitter or my Instagram or whatever, if you ain't got an avatar, I'm not responding to you. Like, you can't even have an avatar, so I know who you are. Two, if what he is saying you know is false, why would you even respond to it? It's like saying, KD, you suck. KD, the second best player in the league. What? Like, I'm like, well, I ain't studying this, man. This is small matters to me. Like, I'm two-time finals MVP, Kevin Durant, several-time scoring champion, Hall of Fame legitimate 6'10 shooting guard that can shoot from anywhere. Why am I responding to somebody that say I suck? Going in the DMs. Like, if it's not a woman that you slide in the DMs, like, why are you doing this? Like, what's the purpose? Like, he is sensitive in that regard.
He is definitely.
Like, but
he's the ultimate. He wants validation. And
why though? And like, you
exactly.
You
like,
got accolades.
You shouldn't care.
Right.
I mean,
but people can't have feelings.
Get out of them at some point. Please.
Because I'm pretty sure LeBron got way more.
LeBron probably has DMs on 10.
Yeah.
Like, look here. First of all, that's why he turned his phone off doing playoffs.
Exactly.
That's what we're coming off of. We know we as humans got feelings, but like, do something outside of going back at people.
Yeah.
Like, especially because they're going to keep coming at you. So
exactly. Especially if they know that it bothers you.
Right. You got to.
Here you go. I found it. It's from Buck Center.
Okay.
Bucket Center. Who's first of all? I'm pretty sure they probably didn't have any followers before KD even went to them, so they should be thanking KD. They have a picture of Kevin Durant, Kawhi Leonard, and Davis, Anthony Davis, and it says three elite two way players, but don't elevate a team quite like LeBron and Steph due to their playmaking and leadership deficiencies.
He said KD, Kawhi, and AD.
So I mean, I don't see why Kevin. I honestly don't see why Kevin Durant
was fighting words,
on this. But at the same time, it's like KD had a reason to respond. Like you said, it's fighting.
Words. Fight word. I ain't know who's saying that. I mean, he including Kawhi and KD. Like,
and AD. So it's like, first of all, if you say anything disrespectful about any three of these players, like yo, your basketball point is irrelevant. Like these are three great players in our league today.
Don't respond because you look at this dude? Like who are you? What's his name again? Bucket what?
Bucket center.
He probably ain't got a bucket in his life, Sloth. Exactly.
So that's what I'm saying. Like, it's like KD, just like stop. I mean, I
KD
like KD.
Called him a knockoff Stephen A.
Okay, that was funny, KD. That was funny. I'll give you that one. All
right, if you're going to come up with some funny stuff like that.
Call him man Stephen B. Smith.
Don't call him Stephen B.
Stephen, none of the above. Nah, so it's like, man, KD shouldn't have went into the DMs, but it's like, if he said something that you felt was disrespectful,
glad KD responded with his actual social media. I'm proud of that. I clap up for that. You know, don't be like the Sixers owner or GM, rather. just straight up respond to that, man. But yeah, he need to chill out, man. Like he need to stop. Just stop, man.
So next we finna go to WNBA versus NBA, the pay gap. So a lot of things has happened last week or so. One in WNBA playoffs when LeBron signed his contract. I forgot who it was.
I think it was Elena Deladon. Was it her? I don't know.
I remember seeing it, but I can't remember her name.
I forgot which one.
It was somebody, but somebody responded and was saying, I wish I can get, or something along the lines of, I wish that was, or no, it must be nice, something like that.
Yeah. Where I can say it from what they were saying, I know a lot of people probably took out context what she said, mm-hmm. whichever player said it, but she was basically saying that, she wasn't saying they deserve 200, what was his contract, 154
million? 100 something million, yeah.
She wasn't saying like they deserve that much, but mm-hmm. she was saying, I think the NBA revenue, they get 50, NBA players get 50%.
Yeah, it was right. Aja Wilson.
Okay.
100%, yeah.
I was from the Aces. Yes.
Okay. Yeah, it was her. Yeah. I remember. Las Vegas thing, yeah.
So, the NBA players get 50% of their revenue.
Right. That's what I learned last week, which kind of changed my mindset about it. They only get 20%, which is crazy to me.
So, yeah, they don't get that much. They don't get nearly as much money.
I think the minimum is $79,000 that the NBA, or average, is $79,000.
Yeah. But at the same time, if the league doesn't bring in that much revenue, you can't ask for a bigger slice of the pie at that point, because we don't have the fan base, the viewer base
to give out 50% of revenue.
Exactly. Yeah, to give that.
So what would make you guys watch the WNBA?
Look here, I don't even watch Big Three like that. I laugh. Right. Big Three.
This is my thing about, okay, I got a question to counter that question. Okay. What is the women's sport that y'all watch? Like, that you will watch a lot of?
Before you answer that, even Serena dead. Williams is retired in this situation.
Serena Williams retired.
And even then, he's saying watch a lot.
What's
what I'm saying.
You got a point.
What's a women's sport that you watch a lot?
Because the only one I basketball. Probably would watch consistently is college basketball.
I don't even watch men's college basketball that much.
I don't watch
you know?
Right, exactly. Because I don't watch WNBA until finals.
I think the problem with the WNBA, as far as like one, making money, two, you know, garnering fan interest, is that the game is just not fun to watch. No, in comparison to a better product, the NBA or men's basketball in general, because it's not to say that women can't hoop, it's women that can hoop, it's women that can beat dudes. Like, man, I know that. They can beat dudes.
There are women that can beat
dudes.
There are women that can beat dudes. Will there ever be a time where we see a woman in the NBA?
No.
Nah.
Why not?
We might see a coach in Becky Hammon.
Yes, I do agree with that. She'll be a coach.
That's coming soon.
Yeah. Yes, I think biologically,
man, we just
it's not going to fit. Yeah. You know, not say that a woman can't play point guard or whatever, but men are biologically stronger, faster, can jump higher, are generally more athletic as a whole. Now, there are more athletic women than I've seen women that can jump like a mug. But like as far as like the whole entire product, the WNBA in America, like not in the other countries because they make more money overseas, is not interesting enough for the American viewer. It's just not. I'm not going to watch it. I watched the finals when it was Minnesota versus LA. That was a great finals.
It's a great finals.
That was a great final. Like, I watched all three games.
You got to watch like the best team. It's like
Maya Moore, Candace Parker.
Those are star-level squads going against each other.
Yeah.
I say, actually, looking at WNBA this year, I'm looking at the teams and look at the standings. It's actually even deeper this year.
Yeah, I agree.
So the playoffs will be even more fun because Diana Taurasi, I don't think she played last year.
She's overseas, or something.
Mm-hmm. She's back this year, so Phoenix is back good. So it's like when the playoffs come around, I'll be watching.
It's good basketball,
but during the regular season, it's – and honestly, with me, regular season basketball is just –
Like, yeah, even in general, that's, like
that's
NBA.
General, yeah, NBA.
NBA, NBA, yeah.
I don't watch regular season unless
it's key games.
Unless it's the
right.
key games or
Christmas, all like around All-Star break, a little bit after when it's getting more competitive.
If I'm just bored one night, and there's some, you know, it'd be on my TV, but do I be paying attention to it?
But I guarantee you, they still get more viewers than the WNBA
they do.
Does, period.
And I don't, as far as like what it would take for me to watch the game, is if I can see the women be allowed to showcase their athleticism more. Now, I was reading an article 2 weeks ago that discussed lowering the rim. And some WNBA players agree with it. Like, yes, lower to like 8 feet. I think it was eight and a half feet, one of them, so they can actually show, like, play above the rim. That's like a big thing that they wanted to do. Now, some of them agree with it. I think it was actually, it was Elena Deladon who for that article was like saying, yeah, I'll be okay with lowering the rim, but that would take some time to get it acclimated to the lower levels.
Yeah,
like,
to shoot.
Like, women's college basketball and high school basketball.
That was joined forces with that as well? Like women high school, women college?
I feel like they should do that because, again,
like that.
It's biological. Like, not saying that women aren't as good because, like I said, I know girls that can hoop.
Me
like
too.
They can ball. They can beat dudes. I seen it in the rec center at the U of M.
As far as, like, the viewership,
yes,
we want to see more athletic.
Like, so I will watch that just out of curiosity.
You see Candace Parker dunk on
– like, two hands probably because she can dunk now.
Yeah.
Like, you know
that'd be nice.
Yeah. I'm like, I feel like
there's no wow factor, really.
Right, now,
but it'll be nicer than just –
like, the women's game, as far as, like, skill, is better than the men's. As far as, like, they're prepared for, like, passing, cutting, shooting, laying the ball up, they're better than the men in that regard. They're better coached, in my opinion. But as, like, athleticism, like, the wow factor, it's not there. Like, what is wow about a game aside from, like, being an intense finals game? Like, you know what I'm saying? Several times during the NBA season, you might not watch a game, but I bet you're going to see a dunk.
Yeah, you're going to see a dunk.
You're going to see a dunk.
And you'd be like, oh, man, that was nice.
Yeah.
Something. But
like, what's gonna be like, the trending video on Twitter from a WNBA game? A layup, a three-point
shot.
Honestly,
it's going to have to be a crossover.
Crossover. And I've seen them, but not as much.
It's still.
With us being a society that's catering more towards women, I can see them lowering in the rim, and it can be a successful.
Now, that I disagree with. I feel like they're not going to do that because of the whole mindset of women want to be treated equal to men.
Yeah. No. I'm saying in the media, as far as media and movies and everything goes, like, women are becoming more and more prominent.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm saying that women are being catered to more, and then that helps with viewership of the WNBA, especially if you giving them something that they can watch.
Mm-hmm.
What you think?
Yeah,
but it's not just them; it's us. You got to make us interested.
Yeah.
It's men.
Another thing they got to do is and this is NBA's responsibility as well, and WNBA. They gotta push their star players more. Like, I feel like I don't know who's a star aside from the ones that I grew up with: Candace Parker, Diana Taurasi.
And we know they're stars because they won championships in college.
In college, not because they won them in the WNBA.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, Maya Moore. I think Maya Moore
is fine.
It's either that they gotta be cold or they gotta be fine.
Yeah. Like, why does Maya Moore not have shoes for girls right now?
Right. She's,
good point.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that might be just Nike. I think she with Nike. Yeah, she with Nike. Like, that's their fault. But I'm like, you need to push shoes for girls.
She got three.
Or even not for girls. Like, guys might wear them too. I don't know. Like, you got to put some shoes or something. Like,
as a shoe collector as I am,
you ain't gonna wear no Maya Moore shoes.
It's not even that. I don't even wear LeBron, so it's just like, it's nothing against LeBron. I respect him. I love him as a player, but it's just like, when it comes to shoes, it's real sensitive. KD don't sell like he should. LeBron,
he used to, but not
LeBron
anymore.
Like, somebody compared LeBron to Jordan stuff. It's just like Jordan sells 2-1 compared to LeBron.
Don't
get me wrong. It ain't all about Jordans. It ain't all about shoes neither, because Kyrie don't sell like that. Kyrie got shoes that sit on the shelves.
Kyrie shoes fresh.
Paul George got shoes that sit on the shelves. It's not all about the shoes or whatever. So it's just like, if Nike dropped a women's shoe, it may not sell.
So what can like shoe companies and like the organizations, associations of women's basketball, what can they do to push their stars? Because they just don't do it for some reason. I don't know why.
It's not only that. Okay, if you get Nike behind Maya Moore, you need to do a collab with Jordan or something. That is the only way you're going to be able to push a shoe. It's got to be a collab with somebody. You either got to do it.
Because there are more women than men in the world. And you would think that women would like be throwing money to this. Like, you know what I'm saying? Or like at least pushing it. But now, for some reason, they're not. Like, it's more of them than us. Like, and I understand it, but I don't. Because I feel like, especially with all the women's movements, and it's been great. Like, for some reason, WNBA is just not getting the push in America. Now, overseas, like, all players are loved. Like, Stephon Marbury is loved in China. Like, women, players, they're like stars overseas. Like, you think about it in what movie was that? Love and Basketball. Mm-hmm. When Monica went overseas, she was loved there. You know what I'm saying? But like here, it's
but
just
this
like,
is America.
Yep, this is America. That's what it is.
The land of the free.
Which is like, again, it's crazy to me. Like, I would be on board. I would love to like see like my, because Maya Moore is cold. Like, she's like cold, but it's, just don't get no push. Don't get no push, man. It's crazy.
It's gonna take the support to get that push, though. Nike's not
gonna,
risk,
support them though. It's thing.
I know, but Nike's not gonna push it if it's not gonna make them money.
Exactly. Yeah.
So at that point, you gotta find something to make Nike pick
should it be
it
the
up.
NBA players, you think?
Yeah, collab with an NBA player.
Collab how though?
I mean, put LeBron and Maya Moore in a commercial together. I don't know.
I think have they been in a commercial together?
Maybe.
I feel like. Well, I know Maya Moore was in the Kyrie Uncle Drew joint, like the commercial. I don't know if she's in the movie.
She was in the movie.
She was in the movie. Okay, but she was in the commercial. So there's that.
At least it was in the movie.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And see, I don't even know who plays like for what teams. Honestly,
WNBA.
Yeah.
Like I said, besides if
that's my
really,
ignorance, but you know,
it's but okay, that's not but your fault if you don't watch it.
They don't promote it like. I don't know when WNBA.
I don't even know when they start. Yeah. I don't even. How many games do they even have a season?
They used to have 32. I don't know.
Difference between 82 and 30.
Yeah.
So that lets you know right then and there, our games ain't that interesting to watch. It ain't even wear and tear on their players. It's just like, we not going to stretch it out. And they have to play during a time that NBA is not like a primary thing.
They play right now.
Dang, NBA is still the primary thing right now.
Yeah, with free agency, not us. So it's like nobody's going to watch it, you know, which is sad because, I mean, I'll watch, with tennis, I'm watching Serena. I ain't watching nobody else.
Exactly. Like, that's with tennis. That's with anything.
They got to promote their stars, like we said earlier.
Yep,
that's what it
that's the big thing, and like the NBA got to figure out something because I mean the NBA they took in the WNBA I think a couple of years ago as far as like helping them out with operating it, but I don't know what they're doing as far as a plan. Hopefully it's working. I don't know, cause I ain't seen it.
So. I don't know if Big Three can get some advertisement. I feel like the NBA, the WNBA can get.
I wonder what's the rating comparison between the basketball tournament and the NBA, like a game, like the highest, well, probably not the highest rating, but like the median rating of like the average of all the stuff. Because the highest of the Big Three I know is probably pretty high because people were like curious to see what was going on with the Big Three.
Mm-hmm. But so. that took Ice Cube and other people pushing it.
Exactly. Yeah.
Oh, the big stars.
It took people outside the WNBA to press that lead.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to tune in because you might get our old stars. You're getting Amari Stoudemire. You're getting Baron Davis. You're getting people we're familiar with. So at that point, it makes you tune in. I'm sorry.
Brian Scalabrine
made me turn in the other night. Brian Scalabrine.
He in a Big Three?
Yes.
White Mamba.
White Mamba.
Nah, bro. We from Memphis, man. Quintel Woods.
Oh, yeah.
His squad serving, man.
But see, one thing I like to see, though, is I like to see a
comparison chart.
I like to see a woman playing the Big Three. Are they playing the Big Three?
No.
I like to see that. It's half court. It ain't full court.
Maybe a little too old.
I would like to see that.
Uh-huh. Not yet.
I wouldn't mind seeing, like, Taurasi get in there or even just a random WNBA player.
I think that's what it's going to take is for a WNBA player. Like you said, they got to do a lot better and market it themselves. But it's like, if I was to see a Hall of Famer WNBA player in the Big Three.
I wouldn't know.
As a woman, I'd be like, okay, maybe I can watch the WNBA. I don't know. I'm just throwing it out. You know?
I mean, okay, quick question. Do they have expedition games like we had?
Exhibition games.
Yeah, like... You know how we'll see, like, the Drew League. That's what I'm saying. At that point, like, you limiting yourself. Besides the season, you limiting yourself. So why not have some games where, like, if we seeing B-Dot, you know, and Famous Lowe's playing in these leagues and stuff like that, and how they advertise themselves, I feel like the WNBA can do the same thing. There's no reason why we should see, like, folks at a high school gym. We see Kobe, James Harden, all them playing in these games, KD, getting people involved. Right. I'm telling you, if you bring Candace Parker here, and Maya Moore and stuff like that, and get it to where it's male and female playing. Like,
we'll be there.
Like they gotta like. And I'm thinking back to when basketball, like before Magic and Bird got there in the 70s, basketball was gonna die. Like it's what it was. It took the NBA embracing their stars with Magic and Bird and like pushing. And even back then, it was a narrative of, you know, black and white. But they in Lakers and Boston, it was that push. But you have to like push the story. Like, what is the story in the WNBA right now?
Nothing.
Like, they got to push the stars and push.
That's the story. That's the story.
Right? Yeah, which is sad. You know what I'm saying?
That's crazy.
What I think it is, like, overseas, they may be pushing a story.
Probably,
where,
yeah.
You know, well, you know, my mom didn't have this. We didn't have this growing up. Because if you think about it, we'll think about Porzingis. Yeah. Players like that come from there, you know, where you see they struggle most of their life and then they get the
That's
chance.
True, because you don't know nothing about no women's players at all. Nothing. Like, you know nothing about nothing. Women's players. Like, I don't know Maya Moore's story. Damn. And Maya Moore, like, so she might be the...
So relatability may be a problem.
Yeah, because she might be the best player of all time. I don't even know anything about her.
She just could have struggled. One day she shouldn't have been here, you know. And it may make people tune in, like, man, you know what?
I'm going to support her. Like, we support...
Y'all need to be listening to this.
Right, like, we support Serena and Venus. That came from freaking Compton. Like, that's enough. That's enough right there.
That's part of the reason. Slick. Because it was like, y'all weren't supposed to make it out playing
exactly.
No tennis.
Like,
of all sports.
That's what I'm saying. Y'all, if anything, y'all make it out playing basketball.
Playing ball, yep.
You know.
That's it. So, yeah.
That's how I feel about it.
But, like, this, I mean, that's the first step is just, one, having the conversation. But I don't, like I said, we don't know what they're doing. I mean, I'm not an NBA owner or executive, so I can't do much. I can just talk about it. But
it's just like, what can we do without costing us so much money to push them on and to
And then to keep us them. Interested in the game is another part of that as well, so.
Okay. Right, that's the end of that segment. Pretty good. I mean, good discussion. Yeah. Great segment.
it involved more than you thought it would.
Being real, man.
Good job, man.
Because it honestly made you think about, like, what does make us watch? Yeah, right. Like, why am I not seeing this?
Exactly.
Like, we see everybody else in Sprite commercials, everything else. Why am I not seeing women like that? Yeah. Why am I not seeing women shoot
It's coming.
What just happened with this discussion and them starting this, that's the first step of it, feel like.
So now, but thing about that is don't get, like, not you, but, like, in general, don't get caught up in just the discussion. Like, what's going to be the action?
It's kind of, now, it's like, that's what's going on with the United States.
We don't know, because.
Yeah.
We not in control of that. We don't deal with that every day. Thing. Yeah.
So, cream, bro.
We'll see.
But, yeah. Definitely 20%, though.
Ooh. I saw that and I was like, shoot. Like,
but at the same time, if they only bring in, we'll say $500 million a year, you know, I'm not finna give you $250 million.
We ain't make no money. Like, we ain't get no money.
We broke even. Like, you know, we ain't make no money. So, you know, it's a little different. I didn't even know they just had 30 games.
Honestly,
like,
this is how I feel. Honestly, I feel like they need to put teams.
Man, we need you talking to Mike, man.
I'm chilling.
I thought we were done, man.
Honestly, I feel like they need to put teams in opportune locations. You have to put, like, for the WNBA. You can't have teams in, like, Los Angeles. I mean, you can, but, like the big market teams. You have First to put put a team somewhere where there's nothing else. Like, no other, like, you can put a team in Memphis, in my opinion. Yeah. Put a team in Nashville. Put a team in Lexington, Kentucky. Put a team where there's, like, good college basketball programs. Like, you put one in Connecticut. Put one in North Carolina somewhere. Put one in.
They got one in Connecticut.
Do.
Yeah, Connecticut,
sorry. Okay, yeah. Like, just put them in the good pockets of women's basketball. Put one in Knoxville, or something. Yeah, and then you gonna get, if the team is good, people are gonna go because they love basketball. Put them in basketball cities, not Miami or
is
Orlando.
One in Vegas?
Yeah, they just, that's the first year. Well, yeah, Vegas getting everybody.
Vegas getting a lot of love now because the hockey team
first
was good.
Hockey team,
yeah,
NFL team coming.
Yeah. Yeah, but, like,
I'm not gonna flatter to see a game though.
You're not, but I'm saying, like, it seems like Vegas is getting, like, a team in every sport, like, simultaneously.
A lot more people are moving out there, and the cost of living is a lot cheaper than LA.
But yeah, like, put the teams in, like, an opportune location where they could, one, make money, two, be entertained. Now, the thing about that is, will we care? Probably not.
Probably not. But,
if you're trying to make money, I don't think women care where they play. They play in freaking Greece and China. They'll play in Memphis, Tennessee. They'll play in Arkansas, Little Rock. You know what I'm saying?
But at the same time, moving to those cities, that's a scare for the people that own those teams in that league.
Yeah.
Because it's just like, that's a risk for us to leave a big city to maximize
but
revenue
at this
and profit.
Point, at this point, you got to take a risk. That's business, right? You got to take a risk because, I mean, right now, I can only name you about, like, four teams in WNBA. The Sparks, the Lynx.
The Suns.
Mercury,
that's what I meant. Phoenix Mercury.
Yeah, I don't even know the other teams. Like,
Seattle and Seattle. Storm.
And a lot of teams, which a lot of teams have.
Sharky ain't going to tell us he watched it.
I know, that's the four teams I know.
And a lot of teams, a lot of good teams have defuncted. Like the Houston Comets, they defuncted.
They ran the 90s.
Yeah. And they were cold. Like Cynthia Cooper, Cheryl Swoops. They had championship history and they defuncted. They were in a big city, played good basketball, but it couldn't make money. Yep. So why not put that team in a city that don't have nothing? Like a basketball town or city that's like it's big enough to support it. Like you put one in Jackson. Well, I'm Jackson, Mississippi. But like in a small city.
First of all, Jackson.
My bad, Mississippi.
You want to say Jackson?
you ain't gonna disrespect my relatives like that.
I got family in Mississippi too.
But Jackson actually is not that bad.
It's a big city, like yeah, a big city in a state.
I feel like they'll support that if they have that.
Right.
They supported Monte.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's just like if you get a star player, a star attraction,
so basically,
they make the game interesting. Jackson,
so basically, put them in small markets. That's how I feel, because that way you're going to get the fan support, because they're going to have diehard fans. Like, you got, like, people go to UConn games, they go to Kentucky, Stanford, all, like I said, the women's college basketball games. They'll go to them, but like, you got to have somebody else. And then, like, I feel like it'll be good for women's basketball, because they'll come right after March, where it's going to be a dead period of women's basketball. Have them going right into the summer like they do now. It's an option, in my opinion. But they're not going to do it because they want the teams in the big city.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So
go like from I there. Said, maximize profit. That's all it's about.
So go from here, man. Time for our new segment. Mr. Savage came up with this one, man. Good job, y'all. Troll or nah. So we're going to have two of us come up with
Bold statements. Bold troll statements.
So
maybe it's not a troll statement. Maybe it's just a bold statement.
Troll or nah?
Or nah.
Let's go to what's your bold statement?
All right, my bold statement.
Your troll statement.
My troll statement. I don't think it'll be much a troll, but it may be.
The fact that it's not a troll is it makes it a troll.
Yeah. Whatever, man.
Or nah. That's the point.
All right, so we talked about this a little earlier in the show.
Okay.
And I'm going to just say it out there. Troll or nah? LeBron James should be compared to Magic Johnson as Kevin Durant should be compared to MJ. To Michael Jordan.
I'm trying to wrap my mind around.
You were going to say Bird.
No.
That is a troll in my opinion.
Why?
So you're saying that LeBron is MJ and KD is Jordan?
Comparison-wise, they should be Magic. More compared. Yeah. Oh, MJ, okay, Magic, let me start. Hold on, let me start that up.
Okay. So he said Ron MJ. He said, "What's got a mic?" I'm like,
I worried about it. I worried about it.
MJ, okay, MJ? Okay, okay.
There's two different MJs.
Yeah, I'm like, man,
go ahead, too. Okay, all right. Go ahead.
All right, troll or nah? Kevin Durant should be compared to Michael Jordan rather than LeBron James.
Why?
I was literally asking why.
So let's take it there. Scoring.
Okay. Kevin Durant has never sniffed a defensive player of the year.
This is true.
Has never sniffed it.
Jordan has multiple.
Like three, I think.
Okay. Let me see.
Who gets defensive player of the year? I know this is off topic.
As a wing player. Now?
So we basically all agree that this is a troll.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Man, I think LeBron is of that hybrid of between MJ and Magic, because he has Magic's playmaking and has Jordan's scoring. I won't say
what I'm trying to say with Kevin Durant is it's like at the end of the game is where I was going with this. You give Jordan the ball.
KD is a beast.
Give Jordan the ball, he's gonna win your game. Even though Kevin Durant does play with the Warriors, even with the Thunder, you give him the ball at the end of the game, he's gonna score. That's where I was going with that.
Okay.
That's what I was going with.
I'll buy some of that because I do agree. Because last year, when he shot that three in Cleveland,
it reminded me of a Jordan move.
That was cold blooded.
He did it 2 years in a row.
Warriors.
Yeah, when he was on Warriors.
Yeah, when he shot on
came up, when they came back from like how much they was down and put in. And
you know what? That's why I was so mad at KD back in 2012 against Miami, because he didn't.
It wasn't Kevin Durant's fault.
I know, it was Russell Westbrook.
It was Russell and James Harden averaged like 12 points a game that season. That player. That finals.
I bought my left hand to people.
Well, he's faster.
Well, I know not to joke. The left hand person.
Choke.
But yeah, I'll buy some of that.
So hold on, troll or nah? Let me rephrase my question. Let me rephrase. In the last 2 minutes of a game.
Okay, there we go.
Kevin Durant should be compared more to Michael Jordan.
So you're saying that LeBron's not Michael Jordan at the end of the game?
At the end of the game. No. That's why I don't think he's the best player ever.
Okay.
If LeBron had a Michael Jordan mentality, I would easily crown
him. I think,
LeBron
Now, well, I always said that LeBron was more Magic than Jordan. I agree with that.
Yeah,
because LeBron does not, he's passive. Like we said earlier, he's passive. And you think about when they won championship against Golden State, who won and clinched it? My boy Kyrie. So it's like, yeah. LeBron, and I don't think that's a shot.
Ray Allen saved him a ring. And,
exactly. You know, and that's not an indictment of LeBron. That's just how LeBron is. He's not a cold-blooded killer at the end of a game as far as like, I mean, he has some buzzer beaters.
He gets Toronto.
Yeah, that don't count. Well, LeBronto. That don't count. That's LeBronto. But yeah, and KD, likewise. I think that's why KD left Oklahoma, because, I mean, Russ going to shoot that shot at the end of the game.
So, we've been seeing KD
do that.
So, trolling off, Ash.
I can't say it's a troll for the simple fact. Like, at first, I used to say KD won't take the last second shot. You know, he doesn't have the ice.
I don't think he wouldn't.
But it wasn't. It wasn't his fault.
It wasn't his fault or anything like that. That's why I said, I'm not going to say it's a troll for the simple fact. Jordan will take that last shot without no doubt in his mind, unless it was just he couldn't get it.
To Paxson.
Mm-hmm. So at that point, you know, KD, even though he went to a 73 win team, it shocked the hell out of me when he started delivering daggers like in the game. Like he, like I'm not afraid of Steph. Steph is gonna smack a three,
and Steph wants to get the ball.
Yeah, but KD been out real deal delivering daggers, sending folks home on purpose.
That's where I was going with that, gentlemen.
Okay. Well, that's not trolling.
Hold on, Sharky. We got trolling off.
I said,
It was an
off. Yeah. When you phrased it in the way with
that's
good. That's about Steve Aguirre. Okay. He always get on LeBron about that last 2 minutes. So
yeah,
cool. All right, I'm good.
All right, Mr. Troll artist.
Troll himself.
What you got? Mind you, this is your first time here.
First.
So we're gonna have a few listeners that rock with us. So if you say something to disrespect them and our numbers are lower,
attack him on social media, bro. Yeah.
I don't even care. You know I'm gonna defend it. So, but basically trolling off. And I really want to know the deep answer to this. And Mark is already getting ready.
What, bro?
First of all, take 2K out of this.
Has to be related to the topics we talked about today.
he can do whatever he wants to do.
He can't. I'm playing.
Take the hate out of 2K for him. But
2K.
Look, Sharky trying to
Sharky. But what's the question?
My thing is trolling off. John Wall is one of the elite, if not the top, one of the top point guards in the league. What is wrong with him besides that he can't be a consistent shooter? People always compare him to Dame Lillard, everybody else. But first of all, Dame Lillard ain't nobody to me. But it's the fact that I feel like he don't get shown the love. Now, of course, when they're in playoffs,
let me help you with this. Let me help you with your troll question. John Wall is a top 5 point guard. Trolling off.
He's top five point guard.
Take that five off. Top three.
Top three. You think John Wall is a top 3 point guard?
Top three. Besides,
he's a troll. At least we got a troll for the show.
He's a troll.
Besides him not being a consistent shooter.
All right. So let's go there.
So okay,
Steph Curry.
Besides him not being a consistent shooter, you can't tell me that it is not a two-way point guard that plays defense, offense, and gives you buttons.
So basically, what he's saying is, who are your top 3 point guards?
My top three, in
any order, it don't matter. Just any of them. I got him. Steph.
Yeah.
I got Kyrie. I got, let me go around the league.
Look at him. He be searching for something. just to say they're better than
James
John Wall.
Count as a point guard.
In my opinion, yes.
I would say no, James Harden is a point
guard. That's a shooting guard.
Even James Harden is a point guard.
What are we looking for in point guard? Just numbers? Controlling a team? That differs.
Yeah, that's different too.
So this is Ash and Troll. What are you looking for as far as like .3 point guards? Why is John Wall a top 3 point guard?
I'm gonna say he's a top 3 point guard for the simple fact he's the whole package. Okay. But like I said, besides shooting, he can drive to the hoop, he can facilitate, he can defend, he can get you steals. He don't mind stepping up at the end of the game. I don't care about Bradley Beal taking the last minute. I don't care about all that.
Are you factoring in leadership?
Exactly. Thank you, Sharky.
First of all, my boy is a leader. Besides Marcin Gortat.
Yeah. What I'm looking for in a point guard, like, this is in my opinion, like if I'm making a team, but it's not necessarily reflecting of my top 3 point guards, if that makes sense. It's kind of weird. I'm looking for a point guard that is selfless, that's willing to get his teammates involved and not...
Does John Wall not do
not
that?
Moan, let me finish. And not moan about it. I'm looking for a leader, meaning that the leader can bring the troops together for the purpose of winning the game. And 3, I'm looking for somebody that can make a jump shot.
and not on 2K.
So, going back, first of all,
he is a B minus on 2K, and he's a 85% knockdown 3-pointer on 2K.
I've only seen John Wall make one jump shot, and that was last year in the playoffs.
First of all, he delivered them when he came back this year off the injury. When I kept tagging you in grooming, you didn't want to pay no mind to
it. You talking about when you was talking to us, talking about y'all gonna be Cleveland, then LeBron them came back from down 17 to 4.
I ain't talking about when Otto Porter got bucketed on. I ain't talking about that. Obviously, that's why I want to trade Otto Porter for Jimmy Butler. Get him up out of there. But he does knock down shots. Now, I do agree that he needs to honestly put in work on the jumper. And honestly, if he does it, he is a threat.
But one thing that kind of pushes me off John Wall is his attitude. Like, whether that's with Bradley Beal, as far as like who doing what on offense.
Teammate, period.
Marcin Gortat, he got him about. Now Marcin Gortat is some trash. Like I ain't gonna deny that was the main beef,
honestly though. Yeah. Like Bradley Beal won a big, like people tried to play that narrative on them two folks. Like, okay, they got a problem with each other. They did at one point, but you gotta think about it. Bradley Beal is 23 years old. And also, he was young.
I never understood the problem anyway because Bradley Beal stayed hurt.
Yeah. Go ahead, too.
He didn't get healthy the last 2 years.
Go ahead, too.
All right, this is what we're gonna do to solve this because we can go on and on, I see, with Ashton.
Yes.
I have a list of 9 point guards who I feel, in no order, are the top 9 point guards in the league.
Okay.
We're going to vote yes or no. Is John Wall better than him?
Gotcha. Like, cool. Gotcha. That's good. I like that.
Is John Wall better than Russell Westbrook?
No.
Is this overall?
How about this? To make it easier for us and our listeners.
Is he better or do we prefer him?
We're GM. we are general managers of our own team, and we're picking.
That's easier. I'm taking John Wall for the big guy.
This is for our listeners, though. For easier listening.
Gotcha.
We're general managers of our own team. I have 9 point guards, and we're deciding on whether John Wall is better than each point guard because this is trouble or not.
Go to him. Me.
Yeah.
Yes or no? Yeah.
We know he is, so all I guess right.
It's not gonna be everybody. You don't know that.
Russell Westbrook, no.
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 I'm gonna say yeah. And for the simple fact is I got a real facilitator on
me. You'll pick John Wall before you pick Russell Westbrook.
Okay.
Oh no, I mean yes with him.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You pick Russell Westbrook over John Wall.
Russell Westbrook, no. Okay. I'll pick John Wall over Westbrook.
Is such player better than John Wall?
You're general manager, would you pick John Wall over Russell Westbrook?
Or doing the player or John Wall?
No. You're a general manager.
Okay.
You got the.
So you say their names.
Yeah, but I'm gonna say their names.
We say yes or no.
We so pick that player.
If they're available, are you gonna pick this player?
That player over John Wall.
Or John Wall, gotcha. Who's
so
available?
If it's yes, I'm picking Westbrook.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha. All right, cool.
If it's yes, you're picking Westbrook. So if it's no, you're picking John Wall.
So
no.
Yes for me.
You're picking Westbrook, Sharky.
No, I'm picking John Wall.
Yes,
really? Oh, Westbrook. Yes. Okay. No, I'm GM. Start my own team. Yes.
I'm picking Westbrook over John Wall.
My question is, why? I just want to know why.
Why would you pick John Wall over Russell Westbrook?
But so I won't be as biased to my opinion.
Because I believe Westbrook. I love Westbrook. I love his. I used to love his. His tenacity. But John Wall used to be the same. John Wall used to be the same type of player. John Wall has learned how to. He's learned how to do what I wanted Westbrook to learn how to do. Slow it down.
We can talk all day about this. We're gonna keep it going though.
So I say yes.
We got 2-for-4 on that one.
Right.
Steph Curry, yes.
I choose Steph over John Wall.
Okay. Just say yes.
Yes.
Would you pick Steph over John Wall?
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
Okay. 4-for-4. Would you guys pick Kyrie over John Wall? Yes.
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 Yeah. Mm. I'm gonna be honest, before this past season, I was saying no.
This past season,
we
changed it.
Okay.
Because Kyrie, yes, he balled out at Boston and everything. That's fine, but. If you would have seen me rocking with them before when they met Boston at first, when IT was at his prime, no.
Okay. Keep going.
Damian Lillard.
No.
We're going to start getting tricky with these.
No.
I'm going with John Wall.
Please. No. We talked about that yesterday. No.
I
love Dame too.
I'm going with Dame Lillard.
I'm going to say push because I can't. It's either one. It's a toss up because I feel like Damian's a better leader and he's way more clutch. than John Wall.
Better shooter.
Did he show you clutchness this year?
Did he show you clutchness this year?
But it's in the past though. Like he's had an off year.
I mean, he played against Warriors in the Warriors he played against?
Pelicans.
Hey, man,
Pelicans tore
their
butt up.
The Pelicans were cold
this season. And Rondo was Rondo. But we're not finna talk about
Dame Lillard and not say he's not clutch. Like, come on.
But he is clutch. It is Dame time, that's real. But yeah.
He going.
But yeah, I think I would lean towards Dame Lillard, in my opinion. As far as like what I'm looking for in the point guard.
So we got what, 2 for 4? All right. Are we counting James Harden?
That's a shooting guard.
We don't have to count him.
Okay, we ain't
got to count him.
Hey, I'm choosing John Wall over him too.
If Chris Paul got to be your facilitator and the person that controls your offense, that is a shooting guard.
Okay, speaking of Chris Paul,
over John Wall?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Like today.
Today, let's go today.
This year, still today.
Still this year.
Yes.
Are we just counting because this man showed up in the playoffs this year?
I mean, Chris.
He always showed up in the playoffs. Yeah,
Blake get hurt.
DeAndre Jordan and teammates. That's what they want.
Give me Chris Paul because Chris Paul is a dog. I'm going to go Chris Paul too. Yes.
I'm going to go Chris Paul.
He'll be a leader for y'all.
I would say yes.
We talking about this year, though. We ain't talking about 4 or 5.
Like this year, like today. Yes.
All right. This should be a good one. Kyle Lowry.
No.
Hell
no.
I better not hear that John Wall ain't been in the vote for them folks.
John Wall's better than that. I'll give y'all that.
We finally agreed on one, guys.
We finally agreed on one.
Like Mike Conley next.
I like Mike Conley.
Nah, I wasn't going to go Mike.
Okay.
But I am going to go Kemba Walker.
No.
I love Kemba, but Kemba, I didn't see Kemba in a contending team.
Playoffs one time.
Because Kemba's good, but he's never played a game of significance.
Yeah.
Kind of like Boogie.
He's a scorer, pure scorer.
Got one more rookie of the year, Benson.
Is he a point guard or y'all?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a point guard.
If he a point guard, yes.
Yes.
I mean, that's
Simmons. I'm taking him.
That's another non-shooting person. I want y'all to recognize this. This is another shooting point guard.
He's like six ten.
John Wall
is a point guard.
Magic Johnson was a.
He's
a point guard because he really likes runs the team.
He's a good point guard. He's not a point guard.
That's a good one. Like I didn't think about Ben Simmons because he's my point guard.
He's a point guard. I'm playing 2K. He definitely my point guard.
Actually, Ben Simmons is my ideal point guard
because. If you can't shoot, I'm much rather you be 6'10 and can't shoot. Because you can.
Yes.
Do everything. I ain't got to worry about nothing else.
First of all, my boy going to get down there and get rebounds. My boy going to go out there and get
steals. And Ben Simmons don't?
Like, I'm just saying. Besides John Wall not being 100% from shooting or even 80% shooting, you can't say that he don't do everything else. I can care less.
I got another one. Lonzo Ball.
That's another one they can't shoot.
Lonzo Ball.
And I like Lonzo.
John Wall, sir. Yeah, John Wall, sir.
Right. You know what? Yeah. I'm picking Lonzo.
Let my man tell me.
I'm picking Lonzo. If I'm the general manager of a team, I'm picking Lonzo Ball over John Wall.
Lonzo is my ideal point.
So you mean
guard.
To tell me if John Wall and Lonzo came in at the same time, you picking Lonzo?
Yeah.
I would.
Without question, my man Tevin.
I'm looking at Lonzo Ball, the best point guard on the squad now, man.
I'm looking at Sharky like, you see this?
When Lonzo Ball finally makes his first All-Star game,
Lonzo
with LeBron now. Lonzo got LeBron and Rondo putting stuff into his brain. He already smart.
His vision is crazy. Do you see some passes?
First of all.
We talking about right
y'all
now.
Sound like y'all talking about Adam Morrison before he became Adam Morrison in the league, bro.
Real talk, Lonzo, okay,
y'all talking about he got this and that. Now I got to see this first. Period.
Hey, he got LeBron in it.
I'm gonna wait till LeBron and them make a difference.
Lonzo is one of four rookies to average. I think it was 10-7-7 as
a
rookie. 10-7.
It don't matter. He a point guard.
He's one of four rookies
all time. How many times Jason Kidd take?
10-7-7.
That's been a minute. I can't even tell you how many.
No, it was some games he took none. It was some games Jason Kidd would have ten rebounds and ten assists.
Yep.
And that's shit. That's a point guard I can draft. He won a ring.
Yeah, man. Look at that gospel, man.
Hey. All right, so hold on. Let me see. I'm trying to think who else in the league point guard.
Mike Conley.
I'm definitely taking John Wall over Mike Conley.
I take John Wall. I love Mike Conley, bro.
But if Mike ever got on a team of significance, if you put Mike with like, do you count the Wizards as a contending team? I don't.
They got Dwight Howard. Now they contending.
For home court advantage in the first round, the number four.
I got a good one. Gary Harris. Jamal Murray.
I'd say Jamal Murray.
Gary Harrison, Jamal Murray. They're basically two.
That's a couple
of the same players. According to the numbers, that was definitely a troll. I didn't think I had to do that. But he's definitely a troll.
He's a troll.
Top three trolls. He's a troll.
We're going to have all this stuff.
We will have sound bites coming soon.
Y'all some John Wall haters. Especially Savage. I already knew it was
going to be. Oh, man. Hey.
I told y'all in the beginning he loved John Wall, man.
Yeah. Man, I just want to
I think
he's
going to get that far, top three.
First of all, I rock with my boy. I've been rocking with my boy since high school. So, of course, I'm a rock with him all the way.
Rock North Carolina, right? I got you.
So, at that point, you know, and when it came to Kentucky, it was just like, folks was like, man, why you going to Kentucky? I was there with Jody Meeks. Y'all mad I'm here still for John Wall? My boy just slapping inside Kentucky.
Hold on, can we just stop talking about that? Because the year that John Wall went to Kentucky, he was supposed to come to the
University. Him and Boogie. Next topic.
Can we end this one?
The whole team
off.
In Kentucky.
I'm sorry to get pissed.
Can we end the show?
This is the end. Follow us, Twitter.
Yeah.
Instagram. LBR Sports 901.
Yeah.
We live from 901. Let's be real. Facebook, YouTube, and Spotify.
We out.
My dog got out of prison and went right back. These brand new don't step on my Balenciaga. I'ma hit that if she let me. They don't like how I talk that. Yeah. Cut it out my wrist, a puddle dripping. 42, I'm steady sipping. Yeah, I'm on and I'm off that. Yeah. These brand new don't step on my Balenciaga. I'ma hit that if she let me. They don't like how I talk that. Yeah. Cut it out my wrist, a puddle dripping. 42, I'm steady sipping. Yeah, I'm on and I'm off that. Yeah. Yeah. I don't follow rules and they don't like that. Hit the club with wife, he brought a dime back. Yeah, hit the three twice and ran it right back. I'm only here tonight cause in the morning got a flight back. Talking it but you ain't living like that. The Porsche cost 100, this is twice that. Flooded on my diamonds, pulling spring. Back in Oakland, I'm a king. I know in Halsey is a ting. Yeah, right detail, it's not a speck of dust on it. I'ma get the bag, you can put some trust on it. Everything is new, so it's never rust on it. And her p's so big, you can park a bus on it. These brand new don't step on my Balenciaga. I'ma hit that if she let me. They don't like how I talk that. Yeah. Cut it out my wrist, a puddle dripping. 42, I'm steady sipping. Yeah, I'm on and I'm off that. Yeah. These brand new don't step on my Balenciaga. I'ma hit that if she let me. They don't like how I talk that. Cut it out my wrist, a puddle dripping. 42, I'm steady sipping. Yeah, I'm on and I'm off that. Yeah. I don't follow rules and they don't like that. I was skipping school to get my sack right. My girl hit me and asked why I don't text back. My dog got out of prison and went right back. Right back, 28 on that scale. Right back to the money, stunning hard, show and tell. Like that, yeah. Versace table, Fendi robe. And I got it out the mud. These brand new don't step on my Balenciaga. I'ma hit that if she let me. They don't like how I talk that. Yeah. Flooded out my wrist, a puddle dripping. 42, I'm steady sipping. Yeah, I'm on and I'm off that. Yeah. These brand new don't step on my Balenciaga. I'ma hit that if she let me. They don't like how I talk that. Yeah. Flooded out my wrist, a puddle dripping. 42, I'm steady sipping. Yeah, I'm on and I'm off that.
Red Christian lose. I rock designer shoes. 100 bands for my coupe. I speed a nigga vroom. Say baby hit my line because he see them stars in the roof. I'm up, not a whole gang. Got 24s on the coupe. Take a L, me never. We in love, I lie. Force what we ride. In the jets, we fly. If he say any respect me, then it's likewise. Another man say from another drive-by. I like the way she say that K. It's like a race. If she bad, I might take her out. Not on a date. Say she bougie, she hit my phone. Cause her late. 100K just off two shows. Spent that in a day.
These brand new don't step on my Balenciaga. I'ma hit that if she let me. They don't like how I talk that. Yeah. Flooded out my wrist, a puddle dripping. 42, I'm steady sipping. Yeah, I'm on and I'm off that. Yeah. These brand new don't step on my Balenciaga. I'ma hit that if she let me. They